this season. So Jay Powell to jump in the center circle against Nick Caldwell, 6'8 versus 6'7. As we are ready to go from Boone. The tip is up, and it's corralled by Dunn. Here comes Ricky Clemens going right to left. We're across from the scorer's table and benches. Clemens gives it to Moksekis into the right corner. Dunn. Dunn will dribble. Give to Powell. Back to Dunn. Dunn, 18 points last night. Slip pass. Moksekis to the hole. Can't get it to go down. Powell comes back with the rebound. Can't put it in. But it goes out of bounds off of the Lions and will stay with Campbell. So Campbell, much like they were doing, did in last night's game, trying to start the game with the Moksekis layup. He just couldn't get it to go down. Shot clock resets to 20. Dunn to inbound left baseline. Having trouble to inbound, now finally gets it inbound to Clemens. Back to the left wing, Carrillero. Crosses over, dribbles, gives to Clemens. Clemens 4 of 5 from beyond the arc. Carrillero, pump fake from 3, called for the travel. And that'll give the ball back to the Lions of Southeastern. Southeastern Louisiana Lions, 2-2 overall, picked to finish 4th in the Southland Conference. That's Boogie Anderson there, leading scorer, number 11 in white, bringing the ball down. Right side it goes to Woodard. Woodard being harassed by Moksekis. Now the switch, loses Carrillero and misses with the three-pointer. Rebound Powell, and here comes Campbell. Scoreless, nearly a minute in. Right side to Clemens, back to Moksekis. Moksekis gives it up to Powell. Powell, top of the key to Carrillero. Carrillero, slip pass, done. The layup goes down. Back door open for the Camels as they start the scoring and lead 2-0. 18:50 to go in this opening half. Ball swung around, left side to Woodard. Woodard gives it to Agnew. Agnew, the UTEP transfer, dribbles into the free throw line wearing the green shoes. He'll back up. Both of these are Under Armour schools. Good move by Boogie. Gets stripped by Carrillero. Back the other way. Carrillero to Powell. Back to Carrillero. Can't hit the layup. And the rebound pulled down by Anderson. Good get back from Southeastern. Agnew, pump fake, puts it up no on the weak side. Unable to get it to go in is McFarland. Southeastern 0 for their first 3 from the floor. Campbell back the other way, leading 2-0, 18-12. 18-12 to go in the first half. Powell stops, pops, long 3 on the way. No good. Rebound tipped up by Woodard and into the hands of Caldwell. Caldwell brings it into the front court with a left-handed dribble. Picks it up, gives it over right side to McFarland. McFarland backs up, faces Powell. Cross-court pass, left side of the key. 3 on the way and good for Agnew. Southeastern Louisiana has their first bucket of the game and leads 3-2. 17:40 to go first half. Dunn into the front court, right side Moksekis. Top of the key, Ricky Clemens. Back to Carrillero. Jesus looks, squares up, right side beyond 3 to Clemens. Clemens with the drive into the right corner to Carrillero. Carrillero loses the ball, picks it up, shuffles it to Powell. 8 on the shot clock. Powell into the corner, still going. Contact, no call. Devin wide open for 3, no. Powell gets the rebound. New shot clock. Powell will dribble drive, get stripped. Go back the other way, Woodard. Woodard leading the break. Campbell gets back, drops it off for Agnew. Agnew, left side beyond 3. Now between the rings, it goes to McFarland. Right side, Boogie Anderson. Anderson, cross-court pass into the corner, caught by Woodard. Pump fake through the lane, gives to Anderson. Anderson off balance in the middle of the lane. No rebound fought for. Clemens tips it with a good box out and gets it into the hands of Dunn. Dunn dribbles up into the right corner. Campbell down 1, 16:42 to go in a slow scoring, sloppy first couple of minutes. Cross-court pass, Moksekis from the corner, in and out. Rebound McFarland. Lions roaring into the front court quickly. McFarland with a high dribble. Gets a blur screen, doesn't choose to take it. He'll set up the offense as he goes back to the Mountaineer logo in black and gold, the big A at center court. Gives it up to that logo, Woodard. Cross-court pass to Agnew. Agnew gets a pick up top. Carrillero on him, 7 on the shot clock. Agnew back, forth, goes around, drops it off. Charge call. Dunn takes the charge, takes one for the team, and gets the ball back for Campbell. Josh Lusane comes into the game as Jesus Carrillero goes out. 16:05 to go in the first half. Lions lead the Camels 3-2. Campbell just 1 of 6 from the floor. Southeastern Louisiana, 1-4. Jason Sinani comes into the game for the first time as he replaces Gidimus Moksekis. Campbell played 10 players last night. Again, a deep bench is key, rotating guys in when you have what for Campbell will be three games in less than 48 hours. Dunn, bounce pass up high to Lusane. With the right-handed dribble, the senior sets up his competition. Coming into the game is the 6'11", Roberry. Dribble drive, Sinani gets partially blocked on his way to the hole. McFarland comes out with it. Back the other way, McFarland, left side of the key. Pushes a pass to Anderson. Southeastern Louisiana up 3-2, 15 and a half minutes to go in the first half. Left side, Woodard, top of the key, Agnew, off the back iron, no. Powell gets almost as high as the rim to pull down that rebound. Impressive board for the very long. 6'8 transfer for Campbell. He gets the ball back, going to try to take the 6'11 man to the hole, but the freshman stays with him. Hand off to Lusane, into the corner to Dunn. Dunn backs up, pushes it down to Lusane. Lusane makes a move to the middle of the lane, back to Powell, three on the way, in and out. Rebound, Woodard. Into the front court in a hurry. Between the circles, Woodard tries to lose his man, Sinani, who stays with him. Back top of the key to Anderson, right side McFarland. Into the right corner, almost thrown away. Agnew gathers it up. Agnew with the high dribble, gives it back left side to Woodard. Woodard looking down low. 10 on the shot clock, can't find anything. Pushes it to Anderson. Anderson averaging 13 points per game, working on Dunn. 5 on the shot clock, turns, pivots, fade away, no. Neither team can hit. Campbell 1-for-8 from the floor, haven't scored in over 4 minutes. Lusane trying to change that, gets his pocket pick, and that'll bring us to the first media timeout. Lions 3, Camels 2, 14:23 to go in this first half. From Boone, this is Campbell Basketball.
We're no etiquette experts, but biting into your McDonald's crispy chicken sandwich and ending up with a whole pickle slice dangling from your mouth isn't impolite. It's human.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Hi, Campbell fans. I'm Christy Yarbrough with RE/MAX United. Thinking about buying or selling or know someone who is? Let me help you make the right moves. It's important to work with the right agent with local knowledge and cutting-edge experience. I can help ease the pains of the buying or selling process by guiding you through the steps. Whether it's connecting you with the right lender, home inspector, handyman for those undone projects, staging and prepping your home for sale, or helping you find the ideal home that fits your family's needs. Visit my website for more information at christy.remaxagent.com. Go Camels!
Step into a quality home you'll value for a lifetime, perfect for your family at every stage. Mattamy Homes focuses on what you value most, with different designs, styles, and finishes crafted to work within your budget. That's why we're ranked first in quality, value, and customer satisfaction. But we don't just build homes, we create communities with instant appeal and enduring value. See what we're building around Raleigh, places you'll be proud to call home. Visit MattamyHomes.com and see for yourself.
Sure, McDonald's breakfast is good. But getting that McDonald's breakfast 2 minutes before it stops being served, that tastes even better.
to go in a low-scoring first half, as you can sometimes expect with the quick turnaround here in the middle of the tournament off the emotion of last night. Both teams a little flat coming out, getting good looks, just unable to hit them. 3-2 the score as Southeastern Louisiana leads. And Campbell with some new blood into the game. Delorso, the Aussie, comes in. Has the ball at the top of the key. Southeastern Louisiana comes out in the zone. The Aussie fires from three. No, and Powell tries to dunk it back in and can't do it. Lusane tries to steal the ball back and can't. Campbell is 1-for-9 from the field, 0-for-5 from three to start off. Campbell has missed their last 7 from the field, haven't scored in nearly 5 minutes. The good news of all that for Campbell is they've been playing good defense. Southeastern Louisiana has not taken advantage The Lions just one of six from the floor. The only points a three from Agnew, who has the ball right now top of the key. Down low it goes to the big fella, number 15, high off the glass. That's Roberry, the 6'11 freshman. Throws up a rock. Clements has the ball, gets around the big freshman, goes baseline, puts it up in traffic off the glass for two. Campbell leads 4-3, breaks open the icy start of over 5 minutes without a bucket. Top of the key, McFarland, over left side to Agnew. Agnew gives it to Eastman into the game for the first time, the 6'4 grad transfer out of Denver. Back over to Anderson. Anderson left side to Agnew. Agnew back to Anderson. Anderson squares off Sinani with six on the shot clock, crosses over, middle of the lane, flies through, puts up a difficult floater that goes in. Sinani had good defense. That was just a good shot. 5-4 Southeastern Louisiana, 13:08 to go first half. Clemens brings the ball across the timeline, gives Lusane top of the key, dribbles left wing, left corner to Sinani, gets by the big man, picks up his dribble, and now gives it the circle to Clemens. High post, Lusane. The big fella out of Atlanta. Into the corner, Clemens, back to Lusane, pinballs around, bounces around, and will stay with Campbell, six on the shot clock. Reyna comes into the game as the man on the Mexican national team. Mexican senior national team comes in for Powell. Medi Pisis, the Frenchman out of Paris, comes into the game for Southeastern. Inbounded to Lusane. Back door, Clemens. Loop-de-loop layup doesn't go down. D'Orso gets the rebound, tries to throw it out. It's tipped around and into the hands of Anderson. Here comes Southeastern. Eastwood flies through, puts in the layup. And it's a 7-4 advantage for the Lions. Clemens brings it across the timeline. Gives it over left side to Sinani. With a high dribble, right side, Reyna. Reyna, bounce pass to Lusane. Lusane directing traffic, puts up a flat-footed three. It goes down. Josh Lusane hits it from downtown. Lusane's second three of the year. We're tied at 7, 8 minutes in. Left side, Boogie, dribbles, drives, kicks it out to Eastman. Good extra pass to Strange. The three rattles home. Matthew Strange, the 5'11 grad transfer from New Mexico Junior College, puts the Lions up 10-7. Both teams have shaken off a icy start offensively. Clemens gets around his man all the way to the hoop and one. Clemens off the glass for two, got bumped up high. Kept it going, puts it in, and he'll have a chance to tie this game at 10. When we come back from the media timeout, 11:38 to go first half. Now we got some buckets going down. Southeastern 10, Campbell 9.
Step into a quality home you'll value for a lifetime. Perfect for your family at every stage. Mattamy Homes focuses on what you value most, with different designs, styles, and finishes crafted to work within your budget. That's why we're ranked first in quality, value, and customer satisfaction. But we don't just build homes. We create communities with instant appeal and enduring value. See what we're building around Raleigh, places you'll be proud to call home. Visit MattamyHomes.com and see for yourself.
Since 2019, the Fighting Camel Club has funded championship-level facility projects such as the Eakes Athletics Complex renovation for Campbell Soccer and a new strength and conditioning space inside Gore Arena. This fall, your Fighting Camel Club donations will fund a new sports medicine facility, a new locker room for women's basketball, and a new digital media lab for athletes to work on their personal brands. Providing championship resources for Campbell student athletes, that's the mission of the Fighting Camel Club. For more information, go to GoCamels.com and click on the give button.
Planning a tailgate? Then it's bow time. Bojangles has everything you need for the perfect tailgate, no matter how many fans you're trying to feed. There's the original tailgate, the super tailgate, and for a really big crowd, the jumbo tailgate special. And if you like your chicken off the bone, choose the Supreme's tailgate special that includes 12 perfectly seasoned tenderloin fillets. So grab the tickets, get that Bojangles tailgate special, and go! It's bow time.
Campbell trails 10-9 for the moment. Ricky Clemens goes to the free throw line out of the timeout to try to tie this game up. The conventional three-point play is made. And with 11:38 to go in this first half, we are tied 10-10. We were stuck at 3-2 Southeastern for about 4.5 minutes. Neither team could score. And now things have heated up considerably, both teams making buckets. Eastman coming out of the timeout brings it into the front court. Left side it goes to Pieces. Gives to Eastman, curls around the corner. Left side just misses the layup. As the underhand scoop shot does not go down. Carrillero back into the game, throws it away. It's a two-on-one the other way. Eastman goes up, can't get it to go down. Rebound tipped up. Reyna brings it down the other way. Reyna left side to Dunn. Dunn takes a look, sizing up the 6'11 guy. Pump fakes and then brings it away. Reyna working. Dribbles through the legs, now brings out to Carrillero between the rings. Right side, Dunn. Dunn, three-pointer over the big man, no. Rebound, Del Orso picks it up, stumbles, picks it up again, and kisses it off the glass for two. Delly gives Campbell the 12-10 lead, 10:40 to go first half. Eastman, Pieces, Anderson, Strange, Roberry, the five on the floor for Southeastern in white. Moksekis, Dunn, Carrillero, Reyna, and Del Orso. The five on the floor for Campbell. Boogie Anderson shakes and bakes. Can't get by the Aussie. Gives it up. Strange from the corner. In and out for the sharpshooter. DeOrso with the rebound. Here comes Campbell. The freshman pushing the tempo. Gives to Carrillero. Top of the key. Carrillero crosses over. Bounce pass. Moksekis can't handle it. It is tipped out of his hands and will stay with Campbell. Campbell to inbound left baseline. Roberry, the 6'11 freshman, goes out of the game. Houston, the UT Rio Grande product, comes in. Del Orso goes out. Powell comes in. From the left side, Dunn, bounce pass. Powell hangs in the air and hits. Probably should have had a foul added to that too, but what an athletic play by Powell. Campbell leads 14-10. It's their biggest lead of the game. 9:54 to go in this quick-moving first half. Right side of the lane, Houston. Houston with a left-handed dribble, throws a dangerous pass, tipped by Powell, goes out of bounds, but stays with Southeastern. In front of the Campbell bench. It'll be inbounded by Mehdi Pieces. There's two brothers from France on the team, Sammy Pieces, 6'3 freshman, Mehdi Pieces, a sophomore out of Paris. Transferred into the program. Eastman with four on the shot clock. It's a high arcing shot that hits the side of the backboard, and then there was a shot clock violation. Eastman, just a 5'9 junior. Put up a shot that might have been partially blocked by Moksekis. 9:30 to go first half. Here is full court pressure, and it's taken out of the hands of Dunn and forced to foul as Moksekis, as Agnew got the ball, just simply ripping it away from Dunn. So Southeastern showing a full court press for the first time in the game. And Campbell turns the ball over. Fifth turnover for Campbell in this first half. Campbell's on a 7-0 run currently. They turned a three-point deficit into a four-point lead for now. Agnew goes to the free throw line. Hits it. He had 15 points in that win against Wyoming. The UTEP transfer averaging just over 10 points per game. Substitution. Ricky Clemens comes in. Reyna comes out. Campbell shooting 38% from the field, just 1 of 7 from three. Southeastern Louisiana, 29% from the floor, 2 of 5 from three. Both free throws go in. Campbell's lead is 2. Full court pressure inbounded to Ricky Clemens. Clemens, a fifth-year senior, dribbles through the legs, keeps going, working on Strange. Brings it across the timeline with 22 on the shot clock. Shovels it to Carrillero. High post. Carrillero, wild throw. That ends up into the seats. Carrillero's third turnover of this first half. Campbell's lead, 14-12. 9:14 to go in the first half. Picking it up. Pieces. Gets a pick up top. Bounces it to Strange. Back to the top of the key. Taking a look. Surveying. He'll give into the left corner. Knocked out of the hands of Houston by Carrillero, but it'll stay with Southeastern. 18 on the shot clock. Pieces, dangerous lob, caught and put in by Houston. Houston made an over-the-shoulder catch with the back to his basket. And we are tied at 14. A whistle and a foul. Dunn pushes Pieces out of the way. Campbell not handling the full court pressure very well. So Pieces, the freshman, to inbound right baseline. Southeastern Louisiana trying to take the lead back into the corner. Three on the way, in and out. Powell with the rebound. Campbell wants to run. Into the front court quickly. Powell, a whistle, a foul away from the ball. And they're going to get Strange holding Moksekis as he was trying to cut through. So three team fouls called on Southeastern, just two on Campbell in the first 11 and a half minutes of this first half. 8:42 to go in the first half, tied at 14. Dunn to inbound, hits Clemens, thinks about the three, but closing in on him was Houston. Now back baseline, Carrillero, quick spin move, hangs in the air and is blocked. Back the other way we go. Agnew, hands off, Pieces three, in and out. Rebound, Powell. And they'll give to Moksekis. Both teams have missed some shots, true, but both teams playing some pretty good defense. Southeastern not letting anything get through. Everything contested. That's what Campbell head coach Kevin McGeehan told us would happen. Powell hits Carrillero, and that three goes down. That was a big shot. Carrillero hits his fifth three of the year. He was 4 of 7 from three-point land coming in. Campbell's lead back up to three. Pieces tries to answer no, in and out, tipped by Carrillero. Dunn has it, goes to the floor. Carrillero goes to the floor, and McFarland goes to the floor, grabs the ball, calls timeout, and that'll bring us to our media timeout anyway. Southeastern calls the timeout at 17-14. Campbell leads. Back after this.
Hi, Campbell fans. I'm Christy Yarbrough with RE/MAX United. Thinking about buying or selling or know someone who is? Let me help you make the right moves. It's important to work with the right agent with local knowledge and cutting-edge experience. I can help ease the pains of the buying or selling process by guiding you through the steps. Whether it's connecting you with the right lender, home inspector, handyman for those undone projects, staging and prepping your home for sale, or helping you find the ideal home that fits your family's needs. Visit my website for more information at christy.remaxagent.com. Go Camels!
I told her I wasn't going to do it.
Hey. Here you go, ladies. I got one Sprite and one high C.
Thanks, but we didn't order these.
Compliments to the gentleman.
Thank you. His mom raised him right.
Get any size soft drink for just $1 right now at McDonald's.
Since 2019, the Fighting Camel Club has funded championship-level facility projects such as the Eakes Athletics Complex renovation for Campbell Soccer and a new strength and conditioning space inside Gore Arena. This fall, your Fighting Camel Club donations will fund a new sports medicine facility, a new locker room for women's basketball, and a new digital media lab for athletes to work on their personal brands. Providing championship resources for Campbell student athletes, that's the mission of the Fighting Camel Club. For more information, go to GoCamels.com and click on the give button.
The double quarter pounder with cheese, fresh off the grill, cooked when I order it and not a moment before, and juicy. Hey, listen, I keep my napkin game up because I'm not trying to have this drip on my drip.
Campbell shaking off a slow start. Both teams started slow. It was 3-2, 5 minutes in. Campbell has heated up a bit, leads Southeastern by the score of 17-14. Inbounded, coming out of the media timeout, 7:46 to go first half. And to the left side, Houston working on Carrilero. Gives it up to Pieces. The Frenchman, bounce pass underneath, blocked by Powell. Rebound fought for, back into the hands of Houston. Pirouettes gives back to Anderson. Anderson was hurt. And they kicked it back out to him. So Anderson now, boy, he's holding the front part of his leg and favoring it. He wants to stay in. But they'll wait and see if they do need to replace him as head coach David Kiefer over on the far side chatting with the official to see if, in fact, Alec Woodward does have to come in, and they will. So Anderson, who wanted to stay in and now is jogging off, will get looked at, no doubt, but Alec Woodard, the Austin Peay transfer, will come in. Campbell leads 17-14, 7:31 to go in this opening half. McFarland puts it in, 2 seconds on the shot clock. Putting it up is Houston. He can't get it. Clemens does. Clemens comes back the other way with a left-handed dribble. He'll turn on the Jets. Back to Carrilero. Passes up a three. Still driving baseline. Stopped on the block. Nice bounce pass. Powell with the shot and one. A fantastic pass by Carrilero. A great finish by Powell underneath the basket in traffic. Campbell is hit. Now six of their last seven from the floor. And Campbell with a lead of five, tying their largest of the game. And Powell trying to make it the largest lead of the game. Pieces with the foul. Powell, free throw goes down. Good news for the Campbell. They're perfect 2-for-2 on the line, converting conventional three-point plays. Campbell leads by six, 7:05 to go first half. Southeastern one for their last 10 from the floor. Good spin move up top. Caldwell throws one. Into the first row, Stan Cole able to catch it with his face, but he's going to be okay. Checked on by the official. That's why he's one of the best in the business. And Stan Cole always knew this job may kill him, and that time he came awfully close. Laser reflexes, though, as Agnew dribbles and drives, can't get it to go in, and the ball tipped up. Gets all the way out to McFarland that puts up a three. No, and fought for DeLorso. Has it stolen, but into the hands of Carrilero. Here comes Powell slashing through the lane. Off balance, manages to kiss it off the window for two. 22-14. Powell has made a couple of high degree of difficulty shots. And Campbell leads by eight, 6:30 to go first half. Pace is at the top of the key with a right-handed scoop shot. Changes to the left, and he misses. Carrilero forced him to alter that shot. Back the other way. Clemens gets to Moksekis. Back to DeLorso. To Carrilero. Carrilero with the right-handed dribble. Crosses over. Gets into the corner. Moksekis. Moksekis dribbles, drives. Cross-court pass. DeLorso three. No good. Rebound McFarland for Southeastern. Races it into the front court, down the right side, turns on the Jets, goes by Powell, hangs in the air. Carrilero again makes him alter his shot. A lot of contact, no call. DeLorso gives to Clemens, back to Powell. Wide open, Moksekis for three, no. Short, and the rebound pulled down by Caldwell. Up ahead to Agnew, good look, wide open on the left side, Woodard. I was just about to say, both teams breathing heavy. This is about the point in the game where your adrenaline is worn off and you realize that you played a game less than 24 hours ago. Both teams gasping for air. We're going to have to get the oxygen out at halftime. Carrilero at the top of the key. Campbell leads by six, 5:12 to go first half. Carrilero hands off to Moksekis. Left side to Clemens. DeLorso dribbles, drives, has his pass deflected back at him. It goes out of bounds off Caldwell. Campbell will keep it right baseline to inbound. With seven on the shot clock, 5:02 on the first half game clock, Campbell leads 22-16, and that's a good timeout. Kevin McGeehan calling a timeout. He's noticing what we are. His guys need a blow. Thirty-second timeout as Campbell will bring the crew together. Final game coming up tomorrow at noon. We've had a lot of Campbell sports going on already this afternoon, and all good news. Campbell women's basketball slapping South Carolina State at home 81-34. Just a big blowout for Ronnie Fisher's team. Our volleyball team that won the regular season, they will play for a trip to the NCAA tournament tomorrow at 4 as Campbell volleyball a straight set victory over Charleston Southern at the Big South Conference Volleyball Tournament. It's being hosted by High Point. Most likely High Point, the number 2 seed, will play Campbell tomorrow at 4. That'll be on ESPN+. And Campbell's football team trying to break a losing streak in their last game of the season. They lead 34-0 at Delaware State and out of conference game. Haj Malik Williams got the start today at QB for Campbell. And the Camels showing up and trying to send their seniors off with a victory, well on their way, leading 34-0. Here, Campbell leads 22-16. Off the timeout, inbounded to Lusain. Back to Dorso. Wide open for three, misses off the back iron. Rebound Anderson. Here comes Southeastern Louisiana. Stops, hesitates, flies, gives a nice pass to the cutting McFarland on the right side for two. 22-18, Campbell's lead that was 8 slips to 4. 4:41 to go first half. Right side Moksekis, back to Delorso. Left side Clemens. To Delorso between the rings. To Clemens. Back to Delorso. Pump fakes from three into the corner. Moksekis passes one up, gives to Lusain. Back to Clemens, right wing. Clemens to Lusain. Corner three, but he stepped out. And the Southeastern Louisiana bench making a whole lot of noise here, trying to bring the energy. Anderson will walk the ball up. 4:16 to go in the first half. Campbell leads 22-18. Boogie Anderson has the ball at the top of the key. Hesitation dribble, trapped on the baseline. Bounce pass out far to McFarland. McFarland will dribble drive, get it poked away by Powell. It's picked up by Caldwell. Caldwell dribbles into the corner. Lusain on him. Caldwell pivots, crosses over, tries to find room, kicks it out. Woodard, a long 3-0 rebound. Had four hands on it. Both were from Campbell. Powell and Delorso. Powell pulls it away. Delorso brings it into the front court. Left-handed dribble. Bounce pass to the right wing, Lusain. Back top of the key, Ricky Clemens. 3:30 to go in the first half. Clemens will dribble. Give back. Lusain, long three. Off the front iron, no good. Campbell just 2 of 12 from downtown. Southeastern Louisiana just 2 of 11. McFarland thinks about a three. Then spills it to the corner, Woodard. Back to Agnew, pump fake from three. Blocked from Powell on the layup attempt. Saved in by Agnew. Out to McFarland, 10 on the shot clock. McFarland dribbles, drives, gives up to Anderson. Pump fake, puts it up from the middle lane, it rolls home. Six nothing run, Campbell hasn't scored in 3 minutes and 40 seconds. Next whistle, it'll be a media timeout. Clemens unloads a long three that swishes home. Had an odd spin on it from the lefty, but it goes in. That breaks the drought. Campbell needed that. Back up five. Both teams desperately needing the media timeout. There's only been 6 total fouls called in this first half. 4 have been on Southeastern. Agnew passes up the three, long two right wing, way short. Rebound, Ricky Clemens. Southeastern Louisiana shooting just 27% from the floor. Powell takes it all the way to the hole. Strip ball into the hands of Delorso, misses the layup. Rebound pulled down by Woodard. Powell fouls him. And that'll bring us to a media timeout. Campbell 25, Southeastern Louisiana 20. 2:12 to go. This is Campbell basketball.
We're no etiquette experts, but biting into your McDonald's crispy chicken sandwich and ending up with a whole pickle slice dangling from your mouth isn't impolite. It's human.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Hi, Campbell fans. I'm Christy Yarbrough with RE/MAX United. Thinking about buying or selling or know someone who is? Let me help you make the right moves. It's important to work with the right agent with local knowledge and cutting-edge experience. I can help ease the pains of the buying or selling process by guiding you through the steps. Whether it's connecting you with the right lender, home inspector, handyman for those undone projects, staging and prepping your home for sale, or helping you find the ideal home that fits your family's needs. Visit my website for more information at christy.remaxagent.com. Go Camels!
Step into a quality home you'll value for a lifetime. Perfect for your family at every stage. Mattamy Homes focuses on what you value most, with different designs, styles, and finishes crafted to work within your budget. That's why we're ranked first in quality, value, and customer satisfaction. But we don't just build homes. We create communities with instant appeal and enduring value. See what we're building around Raleigh, places you'll be proud to call home. Visit MattamyHomes.com and see for yourself.
Sure, McDonald's breakfast is good. But getting that McDonald's breakfast 2 minutes before it stops being served, that tastes even better.
Ricky Clemens has 8 points. Jay Powell has seven. Campbell leads by five. 2 minutes and change to go coming out of the final media timeout of this half. Caldwell pump fake from three from Southeastern into the corner. Another three on the way. Too strong. It came off the hand of McFarland. Campbell shooting 39% from the floor, but Southeastern shooting just 26. So Campbell, the 5-point advantage. Done. Long three off the back iron. No good. Southeastern brings it into the front court. Dumps it off down low. McFarland pump fakes. Blocked by Carrillero. Gets his own rebound. Puts it up and can't get it to go down. Up ahead to Clemens. Clemens knifing through the defense. Finds Dunn. Wide open three. Hit it. Dunn hits the three. That's the fourth of this first half. And Campbell's lead back out to eight, matching their largest lead of this first half. 28-20 Campbell's, 1:10 to go in the first half. Three ties, four lead changes. Campbell has led for over 10 minutes in this first half. Not the prettiest of halves, but Campbell shooting better. Blocked by Lusane into the hands of McFarland and a foul. Campbell just strictly unlucky right there. And it's 28-22. It was blocked from beyond the arc and just fell into the hands of McFarland. So McFarland goes to the free throw line. This is just the third free throw Southeastern Louisiana will shoot in this first half. Campbell has shot just two, and they were on the end of and ones. Both teams called for four team fouls in this first half. 51 seconds to go to complete the three-point play. McFarland misses the free throw. Campbell's lead, 28-22. 20-second difference between the shot and first half game clock. Game clock at 42, shot clock at 22. Clemens dribbles right baseline, takes it all the way to the hole, drops it in off the glass with the left hand. Lions fell asleep. Campbell's lead by eight. Eastman into the front court. 5-second difference between the shot and game clock. Game clock at 25, shot at 20. Down to the right baseline, it goes to Caldwell. Caldwell gives it back to Strange. Left side, back to Caldwell. Three on the way, short. Rebound, Carrillero. Shot clock off, Campbell can hold. Both teams have used their first half timeouts, so Campbell will let it roll here with seven. Clemens goes to work. Gets a pick up top, dribble, spins. Stripped as he goes up. It's gathered on the baseline. A heave, not in time. And that's how the first half will end. Slow start, hot finish. Campbell leads 30-22 as we go to the Mattamy Homes halftime report. It's Campbell by eight, trying to win their second straight in the middle game of this App State tournament. From Boone, this is Campbell Basketball.
Sure, McDonald's breakfast is good.
Oh, Moksekos and Powell. Southeastern Louisiana will bring out their original starting five as well. Caldwell, McFarland, Anderson, Woodard, and Agnew. Across from the benches and the scores table, we're giving you audio with some video extra. Camera sideline is this one not on ESPN Plus tonight. So in the white uniforms, the gold and green trim to start the second half. Caldwell dribbles, goes up over Carrillero, throws it up. No, Moksekis brings it in with the rebound. Campbell doing well on the boards today. Throws it to Powell, who gives it to Clements. Powell might have intercepted that pass meant for Clements, but it ends up in the right hands. Clements right side to Powell. Back on the right wing to Dunn. Dunn wearing the Under Armour headband. Gets it to Moksekis. Gets it back. And Rhythm hits the three. Devin Dunn can shoot the basketball. That's what everybody said during summer camp in the fall. And he certainly did and has here at App. He hits a big three. Campbell leads by 11. Back the other way. Tough basket. Agnew, who had the first points of the first half for Southeastern, has the first points of the second. Campbell leads 33-24, a minute in to this second half. Dunn across the timeline, bounce pass out high to Carrillero, gets it poked away from Caldwell, gets it back. Over to Dunn. Dunn will dribble, drive, right-handed, scoop shot goes down. The Fairley Dickinson transfer out of the capital city of D.C. has the first 5 points for Campbell. Bounce pass to Caldwell on the baseline, turns, spins, Carrillero stays with him. He'll kick it back out to Anderson. Cross-court pass, it goes to Woodward. Bounce pass, Caldwell blocked by Powell. Up ahead to Clements, three on three. Clements, center of the floor, stops high post, trailing Carrillero. Three on the way, too strong. Rebound pulled down by Caldwell. Up ahead, it goes to Anderson. Boogie Anderson, the 6'4 senior, University of South Dakota transfer, kicks out. Three on the way, McFarland, no. The rebound run down by Powell in the corner. He scoops it away, gives it to Dunn. Powell has 8 rebounds to lead the Camels. Dunn crosses over, feeling it now. He'll give it up to Carrillero. Good pass, Powell stripped as he goes up, able to stay with the ball and put it back in off the glass for two. It was a great strip by McFarland. The only thing McFarland could do, and now Campbell is up 13, and Southeastern Louisiana has to call a timeout. Campbell comes out with a flurry to start half number two, leads by 13 with 17:45 to go in this game. Back to Boone after this.
We're no etiquette experts, but biting into your McDonald's crispy chicken sandwich and ending up with a whole pickle slice dangling from your mouth isn't impolite. It's human.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Hi, Campbell fans. I'm Christy Yarbrough with RE/MAX United. Thinking about buying or selling or know someone who is? Let me help you make the right moves. It's important to work with the right agent with local knowledge and cutting-edge experience. I can help ease the pains of the buying or selling process by guiding you through the steps. Whether it's connecting you with the right lender, home inspector, handyman for those undone projects, staging and prepping your home for sale, or helping you find the ideal home that fits your family's needs. Visit my website for more information at christy.remaxagent.com. Go Camels!
Step into a quality home you'll value for a lifetime. Perfect for your family at every stage. Mattamy Homes focuses on what you value most with different designs, styles, and finishes crafted to work within your budget. That's why we're ranked first in quality, value, and customer satisfaction. But we don't just build homes. We create communities with instant appeal and enduring value. See what we're building around Raleigh, places you'll be proud to call home. Visit MattamyHomes.com and see for yourself.
Sure, McDonald's breakfast is good. But getting that McDonald's breakfast 2 minutes before it stops being served, that tastes even better.
What a start to the second half. Campbell on a 7-2 run. Dunn with 5 and Powell with 2. Southeastern Louisiana thought they needed to call a timeout. Just 2 left for the Lions. Into the corner, Anderson. Anderson picks up his dribble, gives it back to Houston. Houston left side, pieces. The Frenchman dribbles, drives, goes up, fouled by Carrillero. And when the Frenchman, pieces, spelled P-I-S-S-I-S, came into the game, just a little bit more umph. Doesn't have any points, but he got a little bit going for this Southeastern Louisiana team. So pieces, the freshman, goes to the free throw line, flicks his wrist, and it goes down. Coming into this game, Southeastern shooting 69% from the free throw line, Campbell 61. There were just a total of five free throws attempted in that first half. Campbell is 2 for 2. Next free throw goes down. 37-26, 17:33 to go. Full court pressure. This gave Campbell some problems in the first half. Inbounded to Carrillero, who calls for his mates to spread out, and he'll bring the ball across the half-court stripe. The Spaniard gives to Moksekis, the Lithuanian, back to the Spaniard. Carrillero dribbles, drives, and a bounce pass that's perfectly placed to Clemens, and it just slips out of his hands. Clemens looks at Carrillero and goes, "That's on me, man." Campbell's first turnover of this second half. They have 10 in the game. Campbell leads by 11, 17-16 to go in this second half. Walking it across the half-court stripe is Anderson. Boogie Anderson has 4 points. He's the leading scorer, coming in with 13 and a third. He looks like it there. Jump stop on the block and kisses it off the glass for two. 3 minutes in. Lions with a mini 4-0 run. 37-28, Campbell's lead back down to single digits. Clemens gets a pick at the top of the key, over left side of the key to Carrillero. Into the left side, Dunn, double team, back to Carrillero. Cross-court pass, Moksekis catches, rises, fires, and hits. G for three. Campbell up 12, 40-28, 16 and a half minutes to go. Anderson into the front court in a hurry. Braids in a ponytail, he'll get it cross-court to pieces. Pieces, the brother of Sammy Pieces. That's Medi Pieces. Scary moment as he fell on his head last night. They put him through concussion protocols in that close loss to Kennesaw State. But he came back in the first half. Throws it away that time. And Campbell will get the ball back as Southeastern Louisiana comes out in the press. It's a 2-2-1 full court zone trap. Dunn navigates, still navigates, brings it across the center stripe and now gives it left wing to Moksekis. Bounce pass to the left baseline, Carrillero. Back to Moksekis, left side from three. Dribbles into the corner, he's double-teamed. Back to Carrillero, fires from three, way short. Rebound, Powell. Gets to Clemens, back to Dunn. Steps into a long three, top of the key. No, long rebound. Carrillero goes between two. Paces falls down and sits on the baseline. And Campbell will get the ball back. Great battling on the offensive boards for Campbell. It's a final from Dover, Delaware. Campbell wins their last football game of the season, 34-7, over Delaware State. Good for Mike Minner's bunch. So Campbell Sports 3-0 today. Campbell trying to make it a perfect day for the Camels. Volleyball and women's basketball also win. Clemens, good pass. Powell, pump fake, gets two in the air, goes up his foul, and he'll go to the free throw line. Great work down low by Powell on the boards, and he has earned a trip to the free throw line. Timeout on the floor, 15:52 to go in the game. Campbell 40, Southeastern Louisiana 28.
Planning a tailgate? Then it's bow time. Bojangles has everything you need for the perfect tailgate, no matter how many fans you're trying to feed. There's the original tailgate, the super tailgate, and for a really big crowd, the jumbo tailgate special. And if you like your chicken off the bone, choose the Supreme's tailgate special that includes 12 perfectly seasoned tenderloin fillets. So grab the tickets, get that Bojangles tailgate special, and go! It's bow time!
Thanks to donors like you, the Fighting Camel Club provides championship resources for Campbell student athletes. Over the last 3 years, donations to the Fighting Camel Club have helped fund facility enhancements and coach-driven projects that have pushed the Fighting Camels to win 27 conference championships. For more information on how you can donate to the Fighting Camel Club, go to gocamels.com and click on the give icon. The Fighting Camel Club, providing championship resources for Campbell student athletes.
Better ingredients, better pizza, better brace yourself, because Papa John's has done it again. Introducing Papa Bowls, No crust, just a whole bunch of those Papa John's toppings you love, baked to piping hot perfection. I'm talking crisp veggies, savory meats all covered in melty cheese, and those signature sauces. Try flavors like Italian Meats Trio, Chicken Alfredo, and Garden Veggie, or get creative and build your own Papa John's.
That last foul was called on Houston, his first, team's first, Southeastern Louisiana. Nobody with more than one foul on the Lions side of things as Powell misses the free throw. For Campbell, they've been called for just five total fouls in the game. Two on Carrillero, so nobody on foul trouble. As Powell eyes the bucket for his second free throw, it goes down. He splits the pair. Campbell 3-for-4 from the line. And the lead for Campbell back up to 13. 15:47 to go first half. A second half that has been all Campbell. Anderson dribbles, gives to the top of the key. It goes to Houston. Houston hands off to Paces. Paces dribbles, wearing number zero. Cuts through the lane. A dipsy-doo layup goes in with the left hand off the window. And Southeastern Louisiana will line up with the full court pressure. Not quite as intense this time. Campbell beats it easily. Dunn and Clemens playing catch. Now Dunn goes to work. Gives to Clemens on the right wing. Back right side of the key to Carrillero. To Clemens, to Moksekis. Back to Carrillero, who will dribble, drive, go up, get blocked from behind. And a whistle and a foul called on the big fella, Brody Roberry. 6'11 freshman out of Meridian, Idaho. So he'll go to the free throw line. That foul for Roberry will be his first, team second. Jesus to the free throw line. Carrillero's free throw off the back iron, no good. Campbell has had free throw problems all season, but they came to an ugly head. They were just 7-for-18 from the line at NC State. Missed 11, a game that they lost by 6 last night from the free throw line. Just 9-for-16, missed 7, so 16-for-34 in the last two games. Campbell altogether this year, just 61% from the charity stripe. Carrillero's second one goes down. So Jesus splits the pair, and it's 42-30. Campbell leads nearly 5 minutes in to this second half. Anderson at the top of the key, dribbles inside the arc, stops at the free throw line, and is fouled. Ricky Clemens can't believe it as he gives a side-eye glance to the referee. Quickly inbound Southeastern. Clemens called for the foul, his first, Campbell second. Paces off the inbound, dribbles, a fadeaway three, doesn't go down. Clemens with the rebound, he gets fouled at midcourt. So Ricky able to draw the foul after the rebound. And Ricky, not very sportsmanship-like, he does an answer to the referee and then kind of rolls the ball down to him. When you're a fifth-year senior, you can get away with that. Paces called for the foul, his second, Southeastern Louisiana's third. Inbounded to Delorso just into the game. To Lusain, back to Moksekis. Moksekis double-teamed, and the big fella steals it. Roberry at 5'11", gives it up ahead to Anderson. Left for Houston. Cuts through the lane and gets fouled. So the big fella with the steal. And Jason Sinani bolts off the bench and will get set to enter into the ballgame. Sinani played 4 minutes in the first half. Campbell has played 9 players in this game, but two of them have just played a few minutes. You could hear a pin drop in here as Houston puts up the first free throw and gets it to go down. 42-31, Campbell leads by 11, 14:30 to go. Moksekis goes out, Sinani comes in. Jason Sinani, the 6'3", 195-pound sophomore, transfer out of Milwaukee. Oak Creek, Wisconsin native. Houston, second free throw. On the way, in and out. Rebound, Clemens. Southeastern Louisiana, 6 for 8 from the line. Clemens brings it across the front court. Gets a pickup tie, left side of the key. Back to Carrillero, right side Del Orso. The Aussie dribbles in, gets bumped out, and gives it back to Sinani. Back to Del Orso, is going to dribble, drive, nice spin, put it up in traffic, is fouled. And we'll go to the free throw line. Campbell thought with the block that that was a goaltend. And they might go to the monitor and take a look. Kevin McGeehan is asking for the review. And I don't think he's going to get it. He is pleading his case to the official on the far sidelines. Del Orso to the free throw line, hits the first. Jose Naves, Jose Carrion, Anthony Burris are our three men in stripes today. Doing a good job. And the second free throw goes in. Campbell's lead back up to 13, tying their largest of the ballgame. Southeastern Louisiana. Eastman brings it into the front court. He's 5'9". Hands off to Boogie Anderson. Anderson crosses over once, twice, still crosses over, gets double teamed, still moving with that motor, finally picks up his dribble and gets it out to Eastman. Eastman puts up a long three over Del Orso. Clemens skies, grabs the rebound, is bumped and falls to the floor. Ricky Clemens will draw that foul now. If there's a little bit of contact, he will definitely make you notice if you're in stripes. He takes a toll for that as well. Gets up very slowly on his hip. Ricky Clemens is one of the tougher players you will see in this game. The former walk-on, now the star of this team. Del Orso has the ball, brings it into the front court. That's the 15th foul on Southeastern Louisiana, by the way. And the second on Roberry. Carrillero from the right corner. He dribbles in, guarded by Houston. Backs him up, picks up his pivot foot, gives it to Clemens. 8 on the shot clock. Clemens, left side to Lusane. Back to Clemens, layup, gets wedged between the rim and the backboard. That's a jump ball, so Campbell will get the ball on the alternating possession arrow. And the shot clock goes to 20, so Campbell catches a bit of a break there, although Clemens makes that shot 999 times out of 1,000. He thought he was fouled. Del Orso gets it into Clemens. Clemens calls a play from the left side with the left dribble. He's double-teamed in the corner, gets it to Lusane. Lusane back to Sinani, top of the key, three, hits every part of the rim and goes out. Oh, my goodness. It hit 5 different parts of the rim and somehow bounced out. Lob attempt on the other end, not wise. Campbell with the rebound. Clemens leading. Euro step, puts it up. No, the tip in on the opposite side by Lusane. Great follow by Josh. Campbell leads by 15, their largest lead of the game. 12:44 to go. Right side it goes to McFarland. McFarland back to Houston for Southeastern Louisiana. Left to Agnew. Back to the center circle, Eastman with 12 on the shot clock. The 5'9 grad student pushes a pass to Houston. Long three on the way, no. Ball goes out of bounds. Campbell will get it back. Powell comes in. Reyna comes in. As Clemens and Carrillero goes out. So Clemens and Carrillero huffing and puffing as they get back. Again, you have played now 1 3/4 games in less than 24 hours. Like you're playing AAU ball again, except the stakes a little higher. Powell on the right side gives it to Del Orso. Del Orso, the freshman. Back to Powell. Powell top of the key. Bounce pass Lusane. Lusane behind the back. Pass to the Aussie who puts up a pirouette layup and can't get it to go down. Great pass. Would have been a tough finish over three white jerseys back. Caldwell looked like he walked. Instead goes all the way in and a charge called. Reyna takes it. And that takes us to a media timeout. 11:56 to go. Campbell looking good. Leading by 15. Ton of time left in Boone.
Step into a quality home you'll value for a lifetime. Perfect for your family at every stage. Mattamy Homes focuses on what you value most with different designs, styles, and finishes crafted to work within your budget. That's why we're ranked first in quality, value, and customer satisfaction. But we don't just build homes. We create communities with instant appeal and enduring value. See what we're building around Raleigh, places you'll be proud to call home. Visit MattamyHomes.com and see for yourself.
Since 2019, the Fighting Camel Club has funded championship-level facility projects such as the Eakes Athletics Complex renovation for Campbell Soccer and a new strength and conditioning space inside Gore Arena. This fall, your Fighting Camel Club donations will fund a new sports medicine facility, a new locker room for women's basketball, and a new digital media lab for athletes to work on their personal brands. Providing championship resources for Campbell student athletes, that's the mission of the Fighting Camel Club. For more information, go to GoCamels.com and click on the give button.
Planning a tailgate? Then it's bow time. Bojangles has everything you need for the perfect tailgate, no matter how many fans you're trying to feed. There's the original tailgate, the super tailgate, and for a really big crowd, the jumbo tailgate special. And if you like your chicken off the bone, choose the Supreme's tailgate special that includes 12 perfectly seasoned tenderloin fillets. So grab the tickets, get that Bojangles tailgate special and go. It's bow time.
Campbell leads 46-31, 11:56 to go in this game. Full court pressure again from southeastern Louisiana. And Sinani runs it into the front court. Double team, but gives it up to DeLorso. Sinani, Powell, Reyna, Lusane, DeLorso, the five on the floor for Campbell. Four newcomers and Joshua Lusane. Back to Reyna, high arcing three off the back iron. No, DeLorso skies for the rebound, tips it up, and it goes off the white jersey of McFarland. That was a good call on a play that was pretty hard to see. We got a good angle for it. We're on Radio Row in what is Campbell's front court now, across from the bench. Campbell in all orange. Slaps the ball. DeLorso gives it into Reyna. Reyna's going to dribble baseline, get double team, give to DeLorso. Back to Powell, top of the key. Powell down the right side of the lane, gets his pocket picked by Caldwell, gets it back. Down to DeLorso, goes up between two, blocked and fouled. It looks like McFarland got the block, but Caldwell may have got the foul. 11:22 to go in this game. Campbell leads by 46, leads 46-31. Campbell built on what was an 8-point first half lead and have outscored southeastern Louisiana after that made free throw by the Aussie freshman, 17-9. Campbell trying to expand that lead. It always happens when you have a double-digit lead in the second half. It seems like that clock is going like a hourglass with wet sand. 47-31 as he misses the second one. It seems like we've been around the 11-12 minute mark for a while. We haven't. There's 11:09 to go. Eastman at the top of the key, over left side to McFarland. McFarland into the corner. Caldwell passes it up, dribbles baseline. Powell cuts him off. Loses it, gets it back, still dribbling. Middle of the lane, that's a right-handed hook shot from eight that's very tough. Caldwell has his first bucket of the game. And with 10:47 to go, Campbell's lead is 14. Reyna races it up, double team, gives it to DeLorso. Campbell has numbers. DeLorso into the corner. Sinani, three, good. Southeastern Louisiana is just about broken. There was a half-court trap by two in the front court as Sinani saves it in to Lusane. We'll hold that thought. Lusane, no look. DeLorso skies, puts it up, no. Rebound, Reyna between two. Has it tapped out of bounds. It'll stay with Campbell. But I was saying back to the previous play, it was a good trap by Southeastern, but it was in Campbell's front court at half court. Campbell broke the trap, and those two men that were at half court didn't run back to help their mates. Campbell had numbers and was able to get a good look for three. And Campbell's lead is now 17. There's a ton of time to go, but Southeastern is on the ropes. Reyna gives to Lusane. Lusane, cross-court pass, deflected to Powell. Powell with the right-handed dribble. Lobs it down low to Lusain. Lusain, one dribble, goes up over the 6'11 freshman and just misses. It's in and out of the rim. Back the other way we go, Woodard. Woodard hands off to Agnew. Fakes left, goes right. And Sinani comes up limping. And he'll be immediately substituted for. Campbell has a lot of guys that aren't quote-unquote injured and can't play. Brock Bidwell, Mason Grant, the only two that are not in uniform, but there's a lot of guys that have some bruises. Charging call. Eastman Skies made the bucket on Joshua Lusain, but the big fella took it right in the chest from the little fellow. It's a charge. The basket is waved off. And Campbell's lead stays at 17. We are halfway through the second half. Joshua Lusain, that can handle the ball pretty good for a big fella, gets a bounce pass to Moksekis, who lays it in with a right-handed finger roll. He nearly dunked that thing. Changed at the last second. Agnew stops, pops from the right elbow, misses badly. Ball goes out of bounds, but it'll go back to Campbell. Four turnovers in the last 4 minutes and change for Southeastern Louisiana. Both teams are tired, but the Lions look a bit broken here. 9:25 to go. There's time for them to come back. But Campbell is firmly in control of this game as it stands, leading by 19. Lusain walks it into the front court. Left side to Dunn. Dunn, top of the key, Reyna. Reyna with a right-handed dribble, fades out into the corner. He has picked up his dribble. His trap gives to Lusain. Joshua Lusain dribbles, gives to Powell through the air. Reverse layup goes through. Powell saw big 6'11 Roberry bearing in on him and double clutched and put it underneath the rim. Into the corner, it goes Strange. Strange passes up the three, dribbles into the middle of the lane. Campbell playing good defense. Lusain with the steal. Into Dunn, two on one. Dunn takes it all the way, blocked out of bounds by Anderson, who gives him a stare down. Southeastern Louisiana has missed some open looks, but let's give credit to the Campbell defense, holding the Lions to 28% shooting. Campbell D held App State to 36% shooting last night. There is a smattering of Campbell fans here. They like what they see as Joshua Lusain goes back to the bench. Gets a round of applause. Lorena Svesteris comes into the game on the inbound. There's an illegal screen called. I think they got Powell for it. Powell will be called for the foul. It is his second, the 15th foul for Campbell. Campbell is in the bonus. Southeastern Louisiana has committed 8 fouls. Campbell just 5. 8:30 to go in the game. Campbell leads by 21. Left side to Strange. Strange looking. Can't find anybody down low. Gives to Woodward that dribbles, drives, and is cut off. Back to Anderson. Anderson crosses over down the right side of the lane. Into the corner. Strange for 3. No. Rebound Anderson, who will puck it back out. New shot clock for Southeastern Louisiana. Anderson all the way to the hole. Drops it down. So Boogie Anderson getting it to go. Boogie's not his first name on his birth certificate, but all it says on the roster is, quote, Boogie. So that's what we call him. Under 8 minutes to go. Media timeout coming at the next whistle. Campbell's lead is 19. Reyna into the corner, gives to Vasteras. Vasteras bounce pass to Moksekis, intercepted. Woodward leads the break, leaves it off to Boogie Anderson, high off the glass for 2. Now Moksekis is slow to get up. Full court pressure. Reyna gets it into Vasteras, who gets it back to Reyna. The San Antonio native brings it across the center stripe with a right-handed dribble. He'll get stripped from behind, diving and trying to get it before it goes into the scorer's table is Woodard. And that'll bring us to immediate timeout. Campbell needs a blow. Up 54-37 with 7:16 to go. Campbell trying to go 2-0 in the tournament. Noon game, the final game of the tournament for Campbell tomorrow versus Kennesaw. Back after this.
Step into a quality home you'll value for a lifetime. Perfect for your family at every stage. Mattamy Homes focuses on what you value most, with different designs, styles, and finishes crafted to work within your budget. That's why we're ranked first in quality, value, and customer satisfaction. But we don't just build homes. We create communities with instant appeal and enduring value. See what we're building around Raleigh, places you'll be proud to call home. Visit MattamyHomes.com and see for yourself.
Since 2019, the Fighting Camel Club has funded championship-level facility projects such as the Eakes Athletics Complex renovation for Camel Soccer and a new strength and conditioning space inside Gore Arena. This fall, your Fighting Camel Club donations will fund a new sports medicine facility, a new locker room for women's basketball, and a new digital media lab for athletes to work on their personal brands. Providing championship resources for Camel student athletes, that's the mission of the Fighting Camel Club. For more information, go to GoCamels.com and click on the give button.
Planning a tailgate? Then it's bow time. Bojangles has everything you need for the perfect tailgate, no matter how many fans you're trying to feed. There's the original tailgate, the super tailgate, and for a really big crowd, the jumbo tailgate special. And if you like your chicken off the bone, choose the Supreme's tailgate special that includes 12 perfectly seasoned tenderloin fillets. So grab the tickets, get that Bojangles tailgate special, and go! It's bow time.
Campbell leads Southeastern Louisiana 54-37, middle game of this round robin 14 tournament. Campbell trying to go to 2-0. They took down the host App State last night. Dunn has his pocket picked. Here's Anderson through the lane, blocked by Dunn, but a goaltend. And you knew Southeastern Louisiana with all this time is going to make a run, and they're making the run right now. Campbell has turned the ball over three times in the last 2 minutes. And with 7:06 to go, Campbell leading 54-39. So Ricky Clemens will come back into the game. Jesus Carolera will come back into the game. Powell and Reyna go out. Moksekis, who was shaken up earlier, he's back out, which is good to see. Campbell will inbound it. Full court pressure still on. Moksekis gives it to Dunn. Dunn wearing the black headband, the orange and black shoes, brings it across the half court stripe. Left side, Vosteris. The junior puts it on the ground, gets it back, gets it to his countryman Moksekis, gets it back, now gives it to Carolero. Carolero penetrates inside the arc, can't get anywhere, gives to Clemens. Free throw line to Moksekis, one more. Dunn, corner three, swish. Dunn has three threes, 13 points to lead Campbell. And the Camels needed that bucket. Back up 57-39, 6.5 to go. Southeastern Louisiana has hit their last three attempts from the floor. Campbell trying to prevent a run that would get the Lions back into this game. That three was a big make. Strange had it, gave it up to McFarland. McFarland dribbles, drives over Vosteris. No, gets his own rebound. Yes, but it's a shot clock violation. Campbell's defense has been pretty darn good this game, limiting Southeastern to just 31% from the floor and just 2 of 19. A measly 11% from the field. Inbounded to Dunn. Full court pressure still there. Dunn gives it to Clemens. Clemens skips it across the timeline, far side to Moksekis. Now to Vosteris. Vosteris has the ball knocked out of his hands. Picks it up. Has it knocked out again and then stolen away. Woodard on a 2-on-1. Gives to Houston. Knifes through. Can't make the gimme. Rebound Vosteris on a good recovery. He'll give to Clemens, who will give to Dunn. Campbell will just have to be inserted as a team into an ice bath after this one. Carolero hands off to Dunn. Dunn into the corner, gives back to Carolero. The Spaniard pushes right side to the man from Raleigh. Clemens at the free throw line, hesitates through the air, off the window for two on the left side. Clemens with that hesitation, and he penetrates and drives and drives, and now it's a 20-point lead for Campbell. Boogie Anderson trying to take this one in his own hands, puts up the runner from the middle of the lane, and a Southeastern Louisiana player shaken up underneath the bucket. Campbell leads 59-41, 5:04 to go. Anderson has come alive here in the second half. As he had just 4 points at halftime, and the leading scorer for Southeastern, now past his yearly average of 13 and change. He's got 14 overall, 10 here in the second half. He's now 7 of 9 from the field. He hasn't missed a shot in this second half. He's 5 for 5. Moksekis all the way out to Carrillero. Carrillero ahead. Left-handed layup goes down. Nearly a five-second call. Instead, a long outlet pass with desperation. Moksekis hit Carrillero for 2. Campbell leads by 20. Right side, 3 on the way. Woodard hits it. That is just the third 3 of the game for the Lions. And Campbell's lead now 61-44, 4:41 to go. Dunn's going to be called for a charge as he tried to get away from the grasp of Roscoe Eastman, 5'9 junior. He's as pesky on defense as his name and his size would present. Dunn called for the foul, his second, team 6. So now both teams in the 1-on-1 bonus for the final 4:40. To inbound from the left side. Anderson gets it in and gets it into Woodard. Woodard back down to the left baseline. Anderson spins once, twice, puts it up underneath the bucket. No, gives it up. And it ends up in Pieces' hands, who puts up an off-balanced shot, draws the foul from Moksekis. That is team foul number 7. It'll be 2 shots for Pieces. So Campbell trying to hang on against a desperate flurry for a Lions team that, remember, used a 17-2 run to make what was a blowout against Kennesaw State into a good game. They eventually lost 72-68, but they have the flair for the dramatic, and they can come back late. Free throw dropped in by Pieces. Campbell leads 61-45, 4:29 to go. In fact, it was about this point yesterday when the Lions went on their run. Dunn goes out of the game. And DeLorso comes in. Inbounded to Carrillero. Carrillero wants Clemens to get into the front court as he motions him away. He'll brings it into the front court. Right side to DeLorso. Left pointer, the key to Clemens, crosses over, gives to Powell. Powell weaves through, goes up over the big 5'6", 11 freshman, and he misses the layup, but it's tipped up, goes around, and finally gets into the hands of Boogie Anderson. Anderson knifing his way through traffic, gives it up right side, 3 on the way, Eastman, it goes down. 61-49, Campbell's 20-point lead has been cut to 12. Full court pressure. Moksekis tries to get it in. It's batted away. And nearly another five-second call on Gidimus Moksekis. He's able to get it in, and that brings us to the final media timeout. Who's going to have a little bit more energy down the stretch? Right now, Campbell ahead 61-49, but the Lions coming back as we'll come back to Boone after this.
Campbell fans, I'm Christy Yarbrough with RE/MAX United. Thinking about buying or selling or know someone who is? Let me help you make the right moves. It's important to work with the right agent with local knowledge and cutting-edge experience. I can help ease the pains of the buying or selling process by guiding you through the steps. Whether it's connecting you with the right lender, home inspector, handyman for those undone projects, staging and prepping your home for sale, or helping you find the ideal home that fits your family's needs. Visit my website for more information at christy.remaxagent.com. Go Camels!
I told her I wasn't going to do it.
Hey. Here you go, ladies. I got 1 Sprite and 1 high C.
Thanks, but we didn't order these.
Come, Mr. Gentleman.
Thank you. His mom raised them right.
Get any size soft drink for just a buck right now at McDonald's.
Since 2019, the Fighting Camel Club has funded championship-level facility projects such as the Eakes Athletics Complex renovation for Campbell Soccer and a new strength and conditioning space inside Gore Arena. This fall, your Fighting Camel Club donations will fund a new sports medicine facility, a new locker room for women's basketball, and a new digital media lab for athletes to work on their personal brands. Providing championship resources for Campbell student-athletes, that's the mission of the Fighting Camel Club. For more information, go to GoCamels.com and click on the Give button.
The double quarter pounder with cheese, fresh off the grill, cooked when I order it, and not a moment before.
.348 to go in this game. Campbell trying to win two straight at this tournament, beating the host App State last night and leading by as many as 21 in the second half to Southeastern Lions. Southeastern Louisiana Lions, and Campbell into the front court, but Moksekis loses it in the corner. And then it's stolen, and Moksekis forced to foul. So it's an 8-0 run by Southeastern Louisiana over the last minute and 11. And with 3:36 to go, the Lions making this interesting like they did last night against Kennesaw State, using a 17-2 run down the stretch to make it a one-possession game late. Eastman's free throw goes in. The 5'9 junior hits it. And trying to make it a 10-point game with this next free throw. That's the 18th foul on Campbell. Both teams with 18 fouls. Possession arrow to Southeastern. The Lions of Southeastern with two timeouts. The Camels of Campbell with three. 61-51, 3:36 to go. Full court pressure. Clemens catches a Moksekis pass, now gives it back. Right side, Delorso. Delorso bounce pass to Carrillero. The Spaniard on the right wing, being harassed, gives it up. Set to pick up top. Delorso bailed out by a foul. Woodard thought he had the steal and a possible turnover, but no. So Delorso will go to the free throw line. We talked about Campbell's free throw woes this season. They've been good today, 7 for 10 overall, 5 of 8 in the second half. So Delorso goes to the free throw line. We're coming into the game. He's a 67% free throw shooter, and he hits the first. That's the front end of what is a 1-1. That'll be the last 1-1. That was team foul number 9 on Southeastern Louisiana. Campbell in the double bonus from here on out. Second free throw to make it 63-51. Rims in. Off the backboard and good. 3:20 to go. Campbell leads by 12. Quickly down is Eastman. A running layup. No. Rebound to Orso. Harassed is the Aussie. He's able to give it away from Carrillero. Jesus back to Delorso. Furious pressure from the Lions and a 10-second call. A 10-second call as Delorso got the rebound and really was being harassed underneath the bucket. And that took a bunch of time. And now Ricky Clemens pleading to his mates to play a little smarter here. 3 minutes to go. Inbound to Pieces. He'll dribble, drive, spin, put it up in traffic. That's a tough shot that goes down. 63-53, 2:55 to go. Here's the full court pressure. Moksekis gets it into Powell. Powell makes the catch at the free throw line in the backcourt. Gives it to Delorso, gets it back. Boy, it's an adventure each time with the way these Lions are playing. I don't know where they get the energy. Right wing, Jesus Carrillero. Back to Carrillero at the high post. Jesus with the dribble, loses his man. Bounce pass to Delorso, goes out of bounds. Was just tipped by Eastman. Campbell catches a break. 2:30 to go in the game. Shot clock at 10. Campbell leading by 10. Delorso to inbound right baseline. Slaps the ball. The Aussie looking for someone. Finds Clemens in the corner. Clemens wants to run some clock. He'll lob it down low to Jesus Carrillero. Carrillero under the basket. Out to Moksekis. Long three on the way. No. Rebound pulled down by Woodard. Here comes the Lions. Up to Paces. Paces in the middle of the lane. Fouled, and it goes down. Paces hits the runner, and it's a 63-55 Campbell advantage with 2:14 to go. every time the Lions get the ball, they're just taking it right into the teeth of the Campbell defense. So Paces goes to the free throw line to try to complete the conventional three-point play. The free throw goes down. And Campbell's lead is 7 with 2:14 to go. Southeastern Louisiana have hit 5 of their last 6 from the floor. Moksekis gets it into Carrilero. Carrilero back to Moksekis. Moksekis working, being hounded. Now double team, gets it across the timeline to DeRosso. Now numbers down to Powell. Powell, a knifing layup, can't get it to go down. Rebound tipped by Woodard into the hands of Anderson. Anderson back to Woodard. Woodard hands off to Eastman. Eastman right side pieces, pull up three, in and out. Rebound DeLorso. DeLorso with 1:46 to go, and Campbell up 7. We'll get it to Powell. Powell to DeLorso across the timeline. And Kevin McGeehan, Campbell's head coach in his 10th season, pleading with his guys to pull it back and run some clock. They'll get it to Clemens at the center circle. On the logo, Clemens gets by his man, goes up over one man, a blocking foul underneath. Clemens saw the Red Sea's part, the shot clock running down, and that's a fifth-year senior move. He will draw the foul and go to the free throw line. Clemens with 12, Powell with 12, Dunn with 13. Jay Powell has 12 points, 9 boards. DeLorso, 7 points, 9 boards. Clemens, 12.6 boards. Campbell is out-rebounding Southeastern Louisiana by 12. And Ricky Clemens hits that all-important first of 2 free throws. So Campbell surviving a couple of haymakers from Southeastern Louisiana. This one not over yet, but you wonder how much more the Lions have in the tank. Campbell leads 64-56, 1:28 to go. Clemens, the lefty, short, and the rebound pulled down by McFarland. Here comes the Lions. Into the front court quickly as Eastman. Bounce pass, pieces, easy two. And it took about 8 seconds off the clock. 1:16 to go, Campbell by 6. Timeout called by Moksekis. And Campbell wisely uses the timeout to avoid the 5-second call. Campbell 64, Southeastern Louisiana 58, 1:13 to go. Campbell's lead was 12 at the 3:20 mark. But it has been the Sammy Pieces show. The Frenchman, spelled P-I-S-S-I-S, has scored the last 8 points for his mates. So Campbell leading by 20 at the 4:58 mark and 12 at the 3:20 mark has seen the lead slip away. Campbell has only not scored a field goal since the 4:58 mark. So Campbell last night getting some clutch buckets late when they needed it, looking for one now. No field goals in the last 3 minutes and 45 seconds to be exact. 1:13 to go. Campbell leads 64-58. Campbell, both teams are in the double bonus now. The possession arrow points to the Lions. 2 timeouts per team. Moksekis, Carrilero, Ricky Clemens, DeLorso, and Powell, the 5 on the floor for Campbell in orange. Paces, Eastman, McFarland, Anderson, and Strange, the 5 on the court for Southeastern Louisiana in white. Inbounded to DeLorso. DeLorso bounce pass to Clemens. Clemens works his way through traffic. Now does a spin move and gets into the front court. He's being hounded by Eastman. Here comes the trap. Clemens gets out of it and gets fouled. Ricky gets bumped, goes to the floor, and we'll have free throws for Ricky Clemens. So Clemens, a 67% free throw shooter on the year, 65% on the career. He has all kinds of confidence, much like last night. He wants the ball in his hands late. Ricky 2 for 3 from the free throw line today. Campbell much better at the line, 10 for 14. They're going to need to hit free throws down the stretch here if they want to win this game. 59.9 seconds to go. Clemens' free throw goes in. Ricky, a hard-fought 13 points, 6 rebounds, and an assist. Next free throw goes down. Clemens hits them both. Those are big, 66-58. Back the other way, pieces all the way to the bucket, and a blocking foul from Moksekis underneath the bucket. It is tough. Boy, the Lions, they inbounded after that made free throw. And it took him literally 3.7 seconds to get from one side of the court to the other, and he's at the free throw line. So that's the thing. Southeastern scoring quickly. Pieces' free throw goes through. Southeastern Louisiana, 11 for 13 from the free throw line. Both these teams came in shooting under 70% from the line as a team. Both have done very well at the free throw line tonight. Neither team has shot well tonight. Second free throw goes in. Campbell, 43% from the floor. Southeastern, 36. Just 12 made threes between the two teams. 56 seconds to go. Campbell leads by 6. Inbounded to Ricky Clemens, who gets fouled. And will go back down the other way. So Southeastern Louisiana can really extend this game again, especially with the way that they are taking the ball down the floor offensively. So Clemens goes to the free throw line again. Campbell leads by 6, 54.8 seconds to go. Misses off the back iron. There are just a handful of Lions fans here and there making as much noise as they can. Clemens lines up and eyes the second free throw, goes down. 67-60. Inbounded to Eastman. Eastman will dribble, drive, hand off, give to pieces, three on the way, and they're going to say he is fouled and will shoot three free throws. He's a one-man wrecking crew. Sammy Pieces is single-handedly trying to get Southeastern Louisiana back in this game. He has scored all the points for them since this team was down 10, 63-53 at the three-minute mark. 48 seconds to go. Free throw number one rims home, and it's 67-61. He hits these next two, and all of a sudden it's a four-point game. Both teams with a couple of timeouts. Pieces hits another. And this to make it a four-point game with 48 seconds to go. Pacis hits it, 67-63. 48 seconds to go, Moksekis to inbound. Long pass, Carrillero out in front, gets stripped from behind. It'll stay with Campbell. And they're going to take a look at it. Carrillero was out in front of the pack. He slowed up a bit, trying to draw a foul, and got stripped. So the Lions, for the second straight night, doing what they seem to do, at least in this tournament, get down big, looking like they're about to get knocked out. Last night used a 17-2 run to end the game and almost come back and beat Kennesaw State. They ended up losing by 4. And here, similar situation, down 20. Have cut this Campbell lead to 4, and if this game, a two-possession game right now, if this call is overturned and the ball is given back to Southeastern Louisiana, look out, 45.4 seconds to go. Campbell will end this tournament tomorrow, round robin affair. It's already known that they'll play Kennesaw State tomorrow at noon. We'll be on the air with the same sort of one video camera coverage at 11:45. Campbell comes back home next week, the day before Thanksgiving, the 23rd at 4, and then Sunday against a real good Stetson team at 1. They'll play Jacksonville on Wednesday, so a couple of good opponents come into town to end November. Kids in free, kids 12 and under in free, for every single Campbell men's and women's game this season. Go to GoCamels.com to get your tickets. You can get them online. You can get them at the gate. We'd love to see you out at Gore Arena. This is a fun team to watch. And they are in a fight right now. The call will not be overturned. So Campbell gets the ball. And Delorso to inbound underneath his own basket, left side. 45.6 seconds to go. Delorso gets it in to Carrilero. Carrilero will bring it out. 40 seconds to go. Campbell up four. Carrilero gives it to Clemens. Back to Powell, and it's batted away. Dangerous pass. And here comes Southeastern. 33 seconds to go. Pieces all the way to the hole. Powell fouls him. And Campbell does not have an answer here down the stretch for Sammy Pieces. He gets that ball, has it predetermined that he wants to go to the hole, and keeps going. That was a dangerous pass by Clemens. Clemens knows it. And now Pieces with 30.1 seconds to go to make it a one-possession game. He does. He has got 19 points now as he's 11 for 11 from the free throw line. This to make it a two-point game with 30.1 seconds. Pieces hits it. And a timeout called by Southeastern Louisiana. 67 to 65 is the score. And Campbell, that led by 20 with 4:58 to go, has ran into a one-man wrecking crew. Neither team has a field goal since the 121 mark. Pieces hit the layup at the 121 mark to make it 64-58. And he has hit seven straight free throws. Campbell has not hit a bucket since Carrilero hit one at the 4:58 mark. They do have six free throws, two by Delorso and four by Clemens. They may not have to hit a shot to win this game, but it has made it awfully tough. 67-65, 30.1 seconds to go. There's a 0.1 second difference between the game and shot clock, so obviously Southeastern going for the steal and eventually have to foul. Inbounded to Delorso. Delorso dribbling, nearly takes up his pivot foot and calls a timeout as he was underneath the basket with his dribble picked up. Campbell has one more timeout. And so does Southeastern Louisiana. And the lead is two with 25.5 seconds to go. Campbell has turned the ball over 19 times in this game, including 10 times in the second half. Campbell has turned the ball over five times in this final 5 minutes of the game. So Campbell happy they built a big lead, now just trying to hang on by their fingernails. Each team with a timeout left and 25.5 seconds to go. So Moksekis to inbound in his backcourt. Underneath his own basket, nobody guarding the inbounder. Clemens gets the ball in. Being hounded by Eastman. Working on Eastman, there'll be a foul on Eastman. And with 21.7 seconds to go, Clemens goes to the free throw line with two huge free throws. '67-'65. Again, as quickly as Southeastern has been getting to the line at the very least, usually in this situation, two free throws, you feel good about yourself. Not so. The Lions trying to roar late again for the second straight game. Clemens' free throw rattles home. That's a big one. Campbell bench breathing a sigh of relief. It's a 68-65 lead for Campbell. This free throw obviously Huge. Ricky's free throw goes down. Two big free throws from Clemens. He's got 18, and Campbell leads by four. 21.7 seconds to go. Inbounded to Eastman. Eastman across the half-court stripe for the Lions. Stops at the top of the key left side. Pieces, dribbles, drives, dumps it off. Blocked from behind Clemens. He thought he had it clean. Anderson will go to the free throw line as the clock stops with 14.2 seconds left. Clemens with foul number three. Moksekis has four. Powell has four. Paces has four for Southeastern Louisiana. An awkward shooting motion for Anderson. Anderson hitched halfway up and was able to get it to go down. Boy, that was one of the more awkward free throws we have seen. It's a three-point game with 14.2 seconds to go. The next free throw, similar motion, misses, rebound. And there's a foul underneath called on Campbell, fighting for the rebound on the missed free throw. And that'll send McFarland to the line now. And the Campbell lead is three. The foul is on Powell. It is his fifth. Lusane comes in, Powell goes out. As Powell fouls out of the game for the second time this year, Powell fouls out, 12 points and 9 rebounds, just a rebound shy of a double-double. McFarland to the free throw line. Eyes the bucket, flicks the wrist, it goes down. Southeastern has shot 19 free throws in the second half and made 17 of them. Campbell has 18 second half free throws, made 13 of them. 13.2 seconds to go. The Campbell lead is two. McFarland to make it a one-point game. Does. Woodard checks in. Strange goes out. 13.2 seconds to go. Campbell's lead is one. Moksekis to inbound. Gets it into Carrilero. Carrilero catches it, immediately fouled with 11.8 seconds to go. So Jesus Carrilero, 62% career free throw shooter, walks to the line. He is 1-for-2 today. Jesus just 1-for-5 at the free throw line coming in. The first free throw from the Spaniard misses. Misses off the front of the rim. And the Lions are going to get a chance to tie or win this game. As a made free throw here will make it. A two-point lead. Carrilero eyes the bucket. Free throw, no good. Here comes Southeastern. McFarland gives it to Eastman. Eastman with seven. Eastman over to Pieces. Pieces. A timeout called with 3.6 seconds to go by David Kiefer. So Southeastern's head coach, thinking that Pieces was trapped out top, he was making a drive to the bucket, but coach called a timeout. So 3.6 seconds to go. Campbell leads by one. And the Camels now fighting for their lives. A couple of big free throws missed there by Jesus. And it is nail-biting time here as Campbell's going to have to come up with a defensive stand. The Camels led by 12 with 3:20 to go. And it's just been a free throw contest here down the stretch. And And so now with 4 point, they'll adjust the clock to 4.2 seconds. Campbell has a timeout left. We'll see what happens once the Camels break the huddle. Moksekis, Clemens, Delorso, Dunn, and Carrillero come out onto the floor for Campbell. For Southeastern, to inbound from the far sideline is Strange. Strange to inbound. Gets it in, top of the key. Boogie Anderson crosses over, puts up a floater that goes down with 0.3 seconds to go. Campbell trails by one and will call a timeout. Campbell tried to draw a charge in the middle of the lane. And now with 0.3 seconds to go, the Camels will need to pull something out of their hat. Campbell will draw up a play to try to salvage this game. Campbell has not scored in the last 4 minutes and 58 seconds. And missing some free throws down the stretch. And we'll see how much time they put back on the clock. I don't think it's going to be a lot. Boy, oh boy, what a furious comeback by Southeastern Louisiana. And that was the first field goal made by Southeastern Louisiana since the 1:21 mark. So the Lions extended this game. And they will not put any time back on the clock. So Campbell, 0.3 seconds down now, 70 to 69. We'll need a miracle. Looking for the tip. Moksekis gets it in. They won't get it off. And Southeastern Louisiana steals one from the Camels. 70 to 69, the final score. And the Lions roar with a huge comeback, as their leading scorer, Boogie Anderson, hits a shot with 0.3 seconds left. Campbell's final game of this tournament will be tomorrow at noon, as the Camels will take on Kennesaw State. A shocker here down the stretch. Coming up after the break, the Shortstop Food Mart post-game plus, as the Camels we'll try to go through this one, as down the stretch, simply Campbell unable to make some shots, and the Lions did. Post-game report coming up after this on the Varsity Network.
This is good. But getting that McDonald's breakfast 2 minutes before it stops being served, that tastes even better.
The Fighting Camel Club provides championship resources for Campbell student athletes. Donations to the Fighting Camel Club have helped fund facility enhancements and coach-driven projects that have pushed the Fighting Camels to win 27 conference championships. The Fighting Camel Club, providing championship resources for Campbell student athletes.
Hi, Campbell fans. I'm Christy Yarbrough with RE/MAX United. Thinking about